Loops are another way to add decision-making to your program. A loop is a control flow statement that allows code to be executed repeatedly based on a Boolean condition. In Java, there are three main types of loops. The first loop is called a while loop, and its flow control looks like this. Here, we check a condition, and if that condition evaluates to true, we do a series of statements and then check the condition again. If that condition is false, we exit the loop and continue to the rest of the code. Looking at this example, let's say we have a variable named x, and it's initialized to be 3, and our condition is x is greater than 0. If the condition is true, we decrement x by 1. Going through this program, we'd start with x equals 3, and since 3 is greater than 0, the condition would be true, and we would decrement x by 1, making it 2. Now that x is decremented, we check the condition again. It remains true, so we decrement x again, making it 1. 1 is greater than 0, so we decrement x again, making it 0. Now when we check the condition, 0 is not greater than 0, so we exit the loop because the condition is false. This loop is called a while loop because we only execute the loop while the condition is true. Let's see what it would look like in code. Here, I've added a couple of print statements to make it a little bit more visual when we run the program. We start with x equals 3 and create a while loop with the condition x is greater than 0. If this condition is true, we run the print statement and decrement x. Once the while condition becomes false, we print out the final x. Let's go ahead and run the program. Here we can see the full execution of this while loop. We had x equals 3, 3 was greater than 0, so we printed out the current x here on line 15. We decremented x, again went through this loop, and printed it 1, 2, 3 times. And then finally, when x became 0, 0 is not greater than 0, we printed out that final x here on line 18. The next loop we have is called a do while loop, and it is very similar to a while loop. Here we execute statements before checking the condition, and if that condition is true, we execute the statements again. Otherwise, we exit the loop. So if we keep the same example that we had before, but change our variable name to y, we would have y be equal to 3, and the statement would be y equals y minus 1. The condition would be y is greater than 0. Here, we would decrement y, making it 2, and then check the condition versus the other way around. Here's what it would look like in Java code. We start with y equals 3 and create a do while loop with a print statement as well as a statement that decrements y. Then we check our condition, which is while y is greater than 0. Once the condition becomes false, we print out that final y. And so running this, here we are. Every time we enter that do, we basically print out y. Here it started at 3, and then when we decrement it and that condition is still true, we get to 2 and 1. And then finally, when we decrement it that last time, 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 is not greater than 0 here on line 28. And then we go ahead and print out the final y on line 29, which is 0. Moving on to the last type of loop, we have a for loop. And this loop is similar to the ones we've seen before. With this loop, we initialize a variable first, check the condition, and then if the condition is true, we execute a set of statements. After executing the statements, we increment or decrement the appropriate variable and check the condition again. If the condition is ever false, we exit the loop. Using the same example as before, but with a new variable called I, we'll start by initializing I to 3 and having our condition be I is greater than 0. For our statements, we'll just have a print statement and we'll decrement our I variable by 1. Moving over to Java, here's what it would look like. We start with this keyword for, saying it's a for loop, and then we create this int I. It's our internal variable and it's going to start off as 3. And while I is greater than 0, we're going to go ahead and do what's in between these curly brackets. And so in this case, it's printing out the current I. Each time we go around and we do this body of code, we are also going to decrement I by 1. And so let's go ahead and run this. And here we have the current I started off as 3. We decremented it. Check the condition. Okay, we'll go again. Current I is 2. We decrement. Check the condition again. Go ahead and print out current I equals 1. And then when we check the condition again, we've already decremented. And so our final I is 0. However, we don't have access to it outside of the for loop, and so we're unable to print it out, unless it's saved in a variable in the outside scope. Loops are great for performing a certain set of tasks repeatedly without having to write repetitive code.